The country's economic and social recuperation from the effects of COVID-19, 21 days lockdown is far from reality, as most people have been surviving with the little they got before lockdown. 80% of the economy of Zimbabwe survives through the informal sector, and even after the lockdown, it is anticipated that it might take more than 3 months for business to start running as they used to be 3 months ago. Post on Sunday this week continued with the effects of the lockdown in the lives of the disabled, the blind and the poor, with this week's edition centers on the deaf and dumb living in Rusape. Dzidzai Utaunashe, a female adult and a vendor who sells earrings, necklaces and movie DVDs at the pavements of number one store. She is a deaf and dumb person married to Leonard, also deaf and dumb with her three children. Two of them are boys, also deaf and dumb, and doing their studies at St. Faith Primary School in Rusape, which caters for people with a disability.
My Ruswa, onogara kuma BC, onora mane kutengesa, machaja, ma face powder, but lo ndo zvakatwa omira kurama kwaanenge achiita kuti vasurvive vana wavo. Kwaendesa kuchikoro nei vanotongo izvezvi pati 21 days izvo zvakatwa omira kuti vaone chikafu chekuti vadye.
Dzidzai narrated the challenges she's going through during this period to put food on the table. She told this publication that she has never received any support from the social welfare, and her worry now is when schools are open, she needs $1,000 for school fees for her two sons, and she is not generating any income at the moment. When this publication visited her at their homestead BC 809, Vengere said since 2009 she started staying in Rusape. To date, she has never received any support from the responsible authorities, but her friend and neighbors who gave her money to buy Millie Mill after the Jock Task Force program was initiated of a door-to-door sale of Millie Mill. Dzidzai is failing to fend for her three kids and wish if government through the Office of the Social Welfare would help the deaf and dumb community as they face social challenges due to language barrier. Post on Sunday there to find out if the Social Welfare Office in the district has an officer who can speak in sign language. Yeah, DJ.